Hey, good morning, guys. So check this out. We're actually going to bring you over here. We have got this thing running this morning. Captain Mark Doty, can you kind of tell me a little bit about this steamboat and what it takes to run this?
Well, it takes a crew of 12 to run the boat. That's the mate, 5 deckhands, a captain, a pilot, a striker, an oiler, and an engineer. And then the food and beverage staff is on board, which brings us up to operating with about 20 on every given cruise.
Okay, how fast do you usually run the Belle?
The Belle usually runs 7 mile an hour on average.
And how many revolutions does that make?
Make about 15 revolutions per minute. Okay. So, and that's what takes to get us up to 7 mile an hour. Okay. On race day, we'll do closer to 11 or 12 mile an hour, and we may have up to 20, 21 revolutions on the wheel.
Really crank it up for that race, yeah. Huh? Not to mention you won.
Yeah, we won this year.
Exciting. And so you guys will have tours on the boat throughout the week for kids, and of course you're going to have your cruises and all that as we head into the summer. It's going to get busy.
Right. And the Mary Miller, our other boat, it will have the dinners and the lunches available almost every day. And the Belle does all the specialty cruises, but we will do the lunches and dinners also.
As the captain, where are you at on this boat usually?
I'm usually in the wheelhouse on top of the boat. I'll greet the customers as they get on, and then I disappear up into the wheelhouse and take over from there.
So we can find you. All right, so to be part of the crew, you got to know a few things, including how to tie a knot. So Julie Stefan, we're about to do this. All right, I'm going to hand you this mic.
All right.
All right. Tell me the story. What knot are we going to
This is try? The bowline knot that we're going to learn today. Okay. It is the most utilized knot on the river when you need a quick eye and a line. There's a trick on how to tie it.
Okay.
You treat the line like it's a tree. There's a hole in the base of the tree there. And a rabbit lives in that hole. And it sees a carrot on the backside of the tree, runs around the tree, grabs the carrot, and runs back in the hole.
So then we pull, did I do it right?
Yeah, you're close.